Liam Neeson.
Hey everyone. It's your boy the Tatumeister, back again. With some fun ass shit.
Some fun ass shit!
Great. So you're probably wondering what the video is about. Oh wait, it's the Commuter review. I'm reviewing the Commuter today. Awesome, with Liam Neeson, directed by, one sec. Ah yes, The Commuter, directed by James Colicciera, who has made a lot of Liam Neeson movies, including The Shallows, Unknown, On Stop, Run All Night. He's a great director. And he brings us The Commuter. Check it out.
Thank you, Doc.
I love you.
It's my first time on a commuter train.
Oh, disclaimer. Vera Farmiga's in this.
Last 10 years.
10 years? You must know everyone on this train.
I'm sorry. Have we met?
No, I'm Joanna.
Michael.
I study human behavior. My job is to answer one basic question.
What's that?
What kind of person are you? Let's do an experiment. What if I asked you to do something that could profoundly affect an individual on this train?
I don't understand.
Someone on this train does not belong. All you have to do is find them. In the bathroom, there is $75,000. That money is yours if you do this one little thing.
I thought this was hypothetical.
You have until next stop to decide. What kind of person are you?
I'm not gonna do this. You're trying to set me up.
No one forced you to take that life.
So, what did I think of this movie? Well, to put it simply, it was freaking awesome. Now, was it the best Liam Neeson movie? Liam Neeson movie that he's ever been in? I don't really know, but it definitely was awesome and definitely met my expectations. I really enjoyed this film. What great about this movie was it wasn't what you expected. Not like Blade Runner was kind of a bad, like, what you didn't expect. My complaint with Blade Runner 2049, if you guys want to go click the link below to watch that review. Blade Runner 2049 was a great film. And yeah, Real Talk's going to go on. John Corona's going to go on a spiel. Oh, Blade Runner 2049 is the best movie of all time. I get it. It's a good movie. But to me, I just felt a little let down in that film. This film didn't let me down. It was great. It was unexpected. It was, like, you know, thrilling. It was an amazing thriller, amazing mystery detective, you know, espionage movie. This was great. And Commuter is relatable because this guy was a regular guy. I mean, Liam Neeson actually plays a regular guy in this movie. You don't really see that happen that much. I mean, Liam Neeson's always playing these crazy detective, like, you know, like badasses and CIA agents and lions and shit or whatever. You don't really see him playing a normal person, but this one, he actually plays a normal person. And it really made the movie so much more relatable. Like, this, what would I do in this situation? Like, what would I do? What would I saw? What would I say? And it just puts you into the experience, which was great. This movie actually, like, put you, like, you were the character. It was cool. I mean, it's like, it was so relatable in that aspect. And it was so mysterious because there was a big twist in the minute movie. I'm not going to spoil it. Just go watch the movie for yourself and you'll see what I mean. Once you watch it the first time, watching it the second time won't be as enjoyable because then you know what's going to happen. But the movie the first time is just great. Like, you don't know what the fuck's happening. You don't know what's going on. And it's just crazy. Like, it's just awesome. I really love the fact, like, mystery movies like that. And we don't get many of those anymore. So, it's a really genre-defying movie. That it was very different from what Liam's other movies that were action-packed and, like, you know, you were expecting, like, a bunch of shit to happen. Like punches and kicks and and blowing up and shit. And there was a little bit, but that was only, like, a really smart part of the movie. The rest of it was a lot of plot-heavy, like, dialogue-heavy shit going on. Which was really interesting to see Liam Neeson do a role like that, because Liam Neeson doesn't do roles that much like that anymore. As much. I mean, yeah, he did Schindler's List, we all know that, but, you know. Mostly you see Liam Neeson kicking ass, you don't really see Liam Neeson actually, you know, doing really deep roles like this, so it was cool. I give this movie an 8.5 out of 10. I don't give it like a 9 or a 9.5 or anything higher than that. It is a great film, but 8.5 out of 10 is my rating, so. It's a great movie, great experience, but it could have been a better. I mean, it could have been, like, you know, a lot better. It was really good for what it was, but it could have been a little better. Like, they could have tweaked a couple things to make it more exciting, but the trailers made it look like it was going to be this action, like punching and kicking movie with a lot of crap going on, and it was a little bit, but it wasn't as, the trailers kind of, you know, were misleading. Not as misleading as the Blade Runner 2049 trailers were, but still a little misleading, because you were thinking this was going to be an action-packed movie, and it wasn't really as action-packed as you thought it was going to be. It was very plot-heavy, which I liked. I liked that it was plot-heavy, because you weren't expecting that, but it was also kind of a letdown in that aspect. It didn't let me down in any other aspect, though. That was my only negative, so 8.5 out of 10. I recommend that you all go watch it. It's a great film, and I hope that other people review the movie, too. I thought, you know, I was super excited when they announced this movie. Like, a few months ago, when I saw the first trailer for this, I was like, oh my gosh, Liam Neeson and Vera Farmiga and Jonathan Banks and all these actors, oh my god. Oh yeah, and Sam Neill. Sam Neill's in the movie for a little bit, like, for about 10 minutes. He plays the chief of police in the end, which is really cool to see Sam Neill in a movie again. You don't really see Sam Neill in movies. I mean, he had that cameo in Thor Ragnarok with Matt Damon, but you barely even notice that Sam Neill was in the movie. So this one, you could actually tell Sam Neill was in it. He actually talks to Liam Neeson in this, which was really cool. Although you could actually kind of barely tell it's Sam. You have to really look at him to know it's Sam Neill, because he has a beard and shit, so it's kind of hard to tell. I'm like, is that Sam Neill? And it is Sam Neill. If you guys know who Sam Neill is, he's from Jurassic Park and a bunch of other old movies. But anyway, so it was really cool to see all these actors on screen together. I'm not going to spoil what happened to Jonathan Banks, though. Jonathan's really cool in this movie, but he's not on there very long. I'm not going to tell you what happens, but and Vera Farmiga was cool too, but she didn't have much screen time either. Mostly was focused on Liam Neeson's character, like Michael. Michael had the most screen time of all the characters, of course, because he's the main character, but still, I feel like that's another complaint I had, was that it focused way too much on him. I feel like they could have got more development on the other characters, but I love Michael a lot in this movie. He's great. I'm kind of hoping they make a sequel, because I'm not going to spoil what happens at the end, but just watch the movie. Just go watch it if you haven't seen it yet. Anyway, so thank you all for watching my review. I will make some new videos later. I'm going to give a little disclaimer, though. The reason I won't be posting videos as much is because my computer is being a bitch. Like, literally. It takes me 20 minutes to turn it on. And then once it's turned on, it only lasts for about an hour before it starts bugging out. So I need to get somebody to fix it or get a new computer or something, because this is just driving me nuts. So, whew, jeez. Let me lower that a bit. I forgot all about that. See, that's another thing. I have to reset everything every time I go into the computer. It's so annoying. I wish I could just, you know, have everything set up, but I have to figure out a way to fix the computer to get it working, and I need to reset it. I just don't know how to reset the computer. But thank you all for watching, guys. Have a great day. Enjoy your life. Bye-bye.